testing the switch circuit in a millivolt system. This video is to show how to check the on-off switch circuit in a millivolt fireplace system. First, you will need to make sure there is good thermal pile readings before you continue. This is covered in the video, Fireplace How-To, Testing a Thermal Pile. Check that out first to ensure a good thermal pile reading. For this video, make sure the pilot light is turned on. If the fireplace is not turning on by the switch, a common mistake is that the gas valve has been left in the pilot position. The gas valve must be in the on position for the main burner to light up. There are different types of switches for millivolt gas fireplaces. A fireplace may have one switch or a combination of switches. Some switches are a unit switch or toggle switch, a remote control, a wall thermostat, or a wall switch. Keep in mind that the switch circuit will sometimes have other safety switches in the circuit, such as a temperature limit switch or a door switch. A fast way of checking to see if the main burner is not coming on because of the switch circuit is to put a jumper wire on the valve. This takes the switch circuit out completely. If the fireplace works with a jumper attached, but does not when the jumper is removed, it means there is a problem with the switch circuit. Use the jumper for testing purposes only, as the fireplace may have a safety switch in the circuit that should not be bypassed during general use. Leaving a jumper wire attached for general use can be dangerous and should not be done. The voltmeter will need to be set to DC volts. It will not read if set to AC volts. The symbol for DC volts is a long line and three dots or lines underneath. To check the voltage drop across the switch circuit, turn the fireplace switch on and place the voltmeter probes on the outside terminals, which are TPTH and TH. The reading should not be more than 80 millivolts DC. This is the millivolt drop. The lower the number, the better in this case. If your readings are higher than 80 millivolts with the switch on, you will need to check the switch or switches in the circuit. One way to check if the switches are faulty is to bypass them. To bypass a switch, you can take the wires off and put them together, or you can use a jumper wire. With the switch bypassed, check the readings on the voltmeter. If the readings drop to an acceptable level, it tells you that the switch you bypassed is faulty and should be replaced. If the readings are still above 80 millivolts, check for other safety switches, such as a high temperature switch in the circuit. Never leave a safety switch bypassed. Bypassing a switch is for testing purposes only, and leaving a safety bypassed can be dangerous. The other way to test a switch is an Ohms test or resistance test. Set the voltmeter to Ohms, which is represented by this symbol. First, make sure your voltmeter is reading 0 ohms when the probes are touching. Then, place one probe to each end of the switch with the switch in the on position. If the reading is higher than 0.3 ohms, then the switch probably needs to be replaced. This test also works on vent safety switches that are normally closed.